I was very concerned at that point about being castable. I was concerned that maybe I wasn't being considered for roles because I was just too unconventional, and maybe I should make more effort to fit in. And then I thought, no, I'm not going to make any effort to fit in. Hi, Vogue. I'm Gwendolyn Christie, and this is My Life in Looks. Before she starts to cry all the way through the filmed feature, this is Brienne of Tarth from Game of Thrones. My goodness, Brienne of Tarth is just so close to my heart. I remember when I first heard about the part, I really wanted to do screen work. That's all I'd wanted to do my whole life, really. I've been told, but just simply because I was a tall woman with somewhat unusual looks, that I would probably never work on screen. But that was a long time ago. And this part had been lovingly crafted by George R.R. Martin, who famously said, when asked, how come you always write such brilliant feminist characters? He says, I always think about women as people. What I loved about this part, I truly couldn't believe it existed. I never thought a part like this would come about in television or in film. And I had to take my hair away. I had to acknowledge my height, my strength, my size, my androgyny, and also my vulnerability. And I also had to really get down the gym, which was probably the hardest thing of all to do. But this part, I will never stop loving. And in it, it was a huge breakthrough for me, and I think has helped to contribute in some small way towards the landscape of how we see women in our modern entertainment. Because the amazing thing was, people love the character. This is quite an extraordinarily emotional moment for me. It felt like such a breakthrough this moment. I'd wanted to be in Star Wars my whole life. I'd been a fan since I was 6 years old. I was so captivated by this band of misfits. It felt like a world that I could fit into. And I also felt huge warmth and embraced by America. And I wanted to wear an American designer. My partner, Giles Deacon, his very old friend, Peter Copping, was the head designer of Oscar de la Renta. And I didn't ever think Oscar de la Renta would dress me. I was a huge admirer of Peter Copping's work since he was at Nina Ricci. And he said he would love to. And he talked to me on the phone and said, Gwen, how would you like to feel? And I thought that was a beautiful way to approach it. And I just wanted to feel beautiful. And I wanted something about this mythic fairy tale of me managing to be cast in Star Wars and play this role that was about breaking the confines of a very closed-down female experience, about inhabiting a different space, about female rage, about a transgressive woman. And I wanted to feel that myth around me. And so I had this beautiful dress made for me with my band of stormtroopers behind me here. She looks fearsome. Vivian Westwood is someone I've admired my entire life. When I was growing up, I was always obsessed with fashion. The reason for it was that I love design, and I love the ability to transform. That's what it seemed to offer to me, that on a day-to-day basis, you could become someone else. You could express something different about yourself. You could inhabit different forms. And I met Vivian backstage at one of her shows, and it was like genuinely a dream come true. She asked me to model in her show. And this was a unisex collection. And what I loved was that I felt like Vivian and Andreas were doing what they always do, what Vivian has always done so brilliantly, which is she has thought outside of the box. She's a revolutionary. She's a rebel. She goes against all conventional forms, but she does it with true excellence. And I felt that this collection was doing that. And I felt celebrated for who I was. This is a Giles Deacon dress. I think the secret is out that Giles Deacon is my partner. And Giles and I have been together for 10 years. Yet again, there's a theme here, something I never thought I'd been invited to. And he said, how do you want to be? How do you want to look? How do you want to feel? And I wanted to feel really alive and vibrant and sexual. And so We looked at different forms. I also wanted to show my back because I was very strong and I wanted to show that strength. It was a true collaboration and I felt incredible. I felt really strong and vibrant and I felt like me. But I will love this dress forever. I've worn it many, many different times. A dress that's truly about love. This is a feature of me modeling in a Mimi show. Beyond the realms of what I thought was possible. The reason this is so special is that we filmed Game of Thrones for a really long time. It was an incredible job. It was a tough job. And at the end of it, I just really wanted to feel beautiful and fabulous. What was amazing was that I went to Paris and my fitting, it was like it was 1991. My fitting was at 12:45. I was incredibly nervous to meet Miuccia Prada, who's always been one of my design heroes. And I came into the fitting room and I was very, very overexcited about being there. I knew some of the people there, Fabio and Katie, and was really excited. And then Mrs. Prada asked us to be serious and asked me if I could be serious. And I felt mortified because I felt like I was worried she thought I wasn't being respectful. She was wonderful to me and she got me to walk around the room and then she said, just walk normally. And we sort of worked on the look. And I walked normally, but I didn't really want to walk normally. I wanted to model, but I thought maybe she can come round to this. So I just walked normally. And then the last time I really modeled around the room, like I'd been waiting my entire life to do. And she said, now that is amazing. This is Tomo Koizumi. Tomo is an incredible person, incredible designer, and I just thought, what an individual, what an individual mind. And Katie texted me saying, what do you want to wear? Do you want to wear the queen? And I said, which is that? And she sent me a picture, and of course, I absolutely wanted to wear it. What did go through my mind, though, was that I was very concerned at that point about being castable. I was concerned that maybe I wasn't being considered for roles because I was just too unconventional and maybe I should make more effort to fit in. And then I thought, no, I'm not gonna make any effort to fit in. I'm gonna work really hard and do my best to be good at my job. I'm gonna honor who I am and every single freakish thing about me. And I decided to wear this. And I remember I said to Giles, I'm gonna wear this. And he said, have you seen the feet? And he sent me a picture from the cover from Women's Wear Daily. And I said, but they won't be feet on me. I'm a foot taller than that model. These will be flamenco style flares like Madonna in La Isla Bonita. And there we go. It wasn't easy getting down those, I think there were at least 50 concrete stairs in the platforms. Katie was very nice. She said, do you want to wear flats? I said, of course I don't want to wear flats. I want to wear heels. So I didn't make it easy for myself. This was the last premiere of Game of Thrones. I was working with wonderful Jerry Stafford and he was working with Iris van Herpen a lot then. And we met and we decided that I would wear this dress. I was so worried about doing this dress justice because Iris is an unbelievable designer. There is no one else quite like Iris. And I was just very nervous about it all. It was the end of Game of Thrones. There was a lot of emotion, but simultaneously, I felt liberated and I felt like this was the opportunity for my life to begin again in a different form. And I walked out onto the carpet and I was just gonna stand, you know. And the photographer said, just one photographer, I think, said, let us see the sleeves. And I just started to come alive. And I just started to do whatever it was I wanted to do in that moment and make that dress work. And to capture the fun and hilarity and energy and pleasure of what had happened in that room with Iris. And this image went around the world. It was extraordinary. This is a Rick Owens look. Rick Owens is one of my favorite designers. Always when it's showtime, if I'm filming, I love to get on Vogue runway and I like to see the looks as they drop. And I saw this look come in and I gasped. But I was wearing all of the incredible Michelle Lamy jewelry as well here, the Hunrod jewelry. I love Michelle Lamy. She is force. She has incredible energy. And I wanted to bring that into this. I wanted to feel powerful. I also wanted to subvert form. I wanted to subvert my shape. As you see, there's some panniers here that come out. The whole center, the focus of the dress is somewhat lower, and it has all of these different panels, like an M.C. Escher drawing. It takes you in all of these different directions. You can see that this is about experience. This is not just a cavalcade of emotion. There is rigor and discipline alongside a raging, vibrant, unique energy. That's sort of how I wanted to feel. I did feel a bit of that. Can we just take a moment to talk about Tom Brown? Tom Brown is a wonderful person and a new friend. It took a long time for me to feel embraced by the acting industry, but the fashion industry did embrace me. For everything about me that society said didn't work, for everything about my loudness as a person, my opinions, my sense of humor, my desire to change and transform, and simultaneously demand to take up space with the body that I was born into, the fashion industry told me that they loved me. And he created this incredible show with layer upon layer of looks. He wanted me to do a performance, which I did for him because I would do anything for Tom. There was an amazing moment when I head out. I was so full of nerves, and you know, all the great and the good are there. Anna Wintour's there, and I looked up into the light and I just thought, it's taken so long to get here. And I've really struck gold in this moment, and I felt transported. And I will never stop being grateful for that moment. And for my final look, we have Larissa Weems. I've wanted to work with Tim Burton my entire life. I cannot believe I've had this opportunity, and I cannot believe how glorious it's been. What self-respecting misfit hasn't watched The Addams Family and thought, that's a family I can fit into? Larissa Weems is very special to me because Tim Burton said to me, do whatever you want with the character. And that was a gift. I wanted to subvert this idea of the Hitchcock heroine. It was a part I would never have been cast as. I would never be cast to look that way. And I wanted this woman to be not a victim, but someone ruthless. Someone that's grown up being in the shadow of Morticia, someone that's used to being second best, someone that's used to nothing ever quite being good enough. And I figured that she would look to our magic portal, to the cinema, in the same way that I had when I was growing up, and would want to embody one of those heroines. I was overwhelmed to have the opportunity to work with Colleen Atwood. I think Colleen had recently bought a secondhand poster of The Birds with Tippi Hedren, and she said to me, that's who I think you are. Incredible moment. And after playing Brienne of Tarth for 10 years and loving Brienne of Tarth, I sort of wanted to play the opposite of that, at least visually. And so Colleen and I had these wonderful fittings where she has a laser-like mind. She always made me feel celebrated. She made me feel that my body was beautiful, I am beautiful, that I wear clothes well, that my ideas were welcome and relevant. And I changed my silhouette a little bit. I'm not telling you because I'm not gonna tell you everything. But we altered and changed the silhouette a little bit. But we kept her shoulders strong and these strong collars so that the face was always presented. Certainly in Game of Thrones, when I was playing Brienne of Tarth, that character was having to overcome a lot of shame regarding the way society treated the character. But this is a character who is bold and assured and proud and presenting herself to the world. The geniuses I've worked with have been open, and together we've created some things that I really do feel proud of. They're fun, they're alive, they're an expression of me and who I am in that moment. We all have our nerves, we all feel strange and have our insecurities. But in those moments, I feel a great deal of happiness and joy. And I so appreciate that generosity. The generosity of Giles, generosity of Rick Owens, the generosity of Colleen, all the people I work with. There are too many to name, but it's a community. And I'm so grateful to be a part of it. And that was My Life in Looks. Thank you for having me, Vogue. I hope you've enjoyed it as much as I have.